First of all, let me thank Mr. Kadir for inviting me to this conference. Not only to this conference, he presented a charter of demands, which I thought ever since a great thing. IBA, as I understand, in annual conferences, discusses several issues facing the broken community and, insurance industry, and arrive at a sort of understanding among all the members what the real issues are, what can be sorted. That's a welcome sign. Today we have a theme also, brokers dedicated to growth and penetration of insurance, of business, not insurance, business. And we have seen a presentation also on that, and growth and penetration. If you look at India insurance scene, the first insurance broking license was issued by IRDA on 30th January 2003. As on 30th June 2013, there are 300 direct brokers, composite brokers, and 6 reinsurance brokers operating in the country. During the financial year 12-13, we observed that the insurance brokers have produced for non-life insurers around 14,700 crore of business, more than 21% of the total premium, of gross direct premium under 92 lakh policies, which is 8% of the total. Similarly, life insurers, the insurance brokers have procured almost 1,300 crore of business, which is roughly 1.2% of the total. Of total new business premium. The data clearly indicates that so far, insurance brokers have been relatively more active in the area of non-life insurance, and that too in commercial lines of business, as 21% of premium is coming under 8% of policies. Insurance brokers among various distribution channels have the unique characteristics of representing the customer. It is thus imperative for a broker with due consideration of client's needs to design and identify appropriate insurance covers. Low awareness among most of the clients about the range of risks they are subjected to is a key challenge faced by the brokers. The issue could be addressed by appropriately communicating existence of risk covers and importance of effectively managing those risks for financial well-being of the client. Increased awareness among clients about the range of risks being faced by them would result in the increased appreciation of the role of insurance solutions in effective risk management and ensuring their financial well-being. In the de-tariffed non-life insurance market, the efforts of insurance brokers in bringing down the premium rates in some of the product categories like property, health, catering to the needs of corporate segments is appreciable one, though I don't know whether CEOs of companies will appreciate this efforts by them, as there is no scope for cross-subsidization in any developed markets. However, so far, the contribution of brokers in designing customized product to cater to retail market segment is relatively low level. In marketing the standardized retail products like motor, the role of brokers is limited with respect to customizing the product to the specific needs of the client. In this context, the broker, though representing customer more or less, appear to be selling insurance products like other distribution channels. The brokers could inspire insurers to enhance the bouquet of add-on or rider covers being offered, which cater to the genuine needs of customers. With appropriate choice made from the available bouquet, customized insurance solutions in the retail segment could be suggested by insurance brokers commensurate with clients' needs. Such customized solutions would be more appealing to customers and enhance utility of the service offered by brokers. In a typical retail insurance product, maybe it is life or non-life, policy issue and cost and marketing cost, particularly those associated with the first time sale of the product, are significant. In most of the situations, to make it viable in the hands of the customer, such first sale costs could be recovered by the insurer during more than one policy period. The more the period of recovery, the more would be the cost of capital employed by the insurers. However, if an insurer is having confidence in the relationship continuing beyond policy period, first policy period, the cost could be moderate in view of the future profit avenues made available by the relationship to the insurers. This clearly indicates the critical nature of having highly persistent business, as it would offer better value to the customer, and at the same time it would benefit the insurer and the insurance brokers with a stable income stream. As the insurance broker chooses insurance coverage for the client based on a professional assessment of his risk profile and financial needs, it is reasonable to expect a higher level of persistency in respect of retail policies procured by them, as it is well established fact that a satisfied customer would be continuing the relationship, and the same would result in a win-win situation of all stakeholders. Making sure that the insurance product available in the market at a reasonable cost and with their fair terms has always been focus area of the regulator. Practice of some of the insurers to offer extravagant remuneration to some of the intermediaries under the guise of reimbursement or otherwise was cause of concern for regulator. In any such unreasonable expenses incurred in offering insurance services would ultimately increase the cost of insurance protection to the end users. IRDA has issued regulations covering life insurance product and health insurance product. Primary objective in bringing out this regulation is to ensure reasonable and fair treatment to the policyholders at various stages of the policy, namely sales, policy servicing and claim settlement, and protecting the long-term nature of the life insurance product. Ensuring reasonable returns and necessary life insurance cover to the policyholders under savings-linked insurance product, and providing necessary health insurance cover and renewability under health insurance product are major objectives expected to be achieved with these regulations. It's a fact that the more an insurance policyholder comprehends the benefit and features and other terms and conditions of the insurance product purchase, the more would be the utility of the product for him and improve the possibility of a continued relationship with the insurance industry. Improvement in penetration achieved through reasonably priced products is good for the customer as well as for the industry. Insurance brokers shall ensure to put in place necessary post-sale service procedures to cater to the needs of the clients in close coordination with the respective insurers. The role of brokers in ensuring necessary updating of the client's records with the insurers and ensuring the prompt delivery of renewal intimations to the clients is important in maintaining insurance protection. Policy servicing mechanism, in particular for claims, adopted by insurance brokers would be critical in enhancing the credibility among the clients.